Now, this is one question, you know, which has come up to one of my friends, you know, who had gone for a .NET interview. And I'm very surprised with this question, but I thought that I'll make a small video on this and I'll explain it. So basically, the question what was asked to him was that you have two classes. You can see down below, there is Class1 and Class2. And what's happening here is that Class1 actually creates the object of Class2, and Class2 actually creates the object of Class1. Okay. Now, if we go and create the object of Class1, what will happen to this code? So again, I'll repeat the question. We have two classes, Class1 and Class2, and each of these classes are creating the object of each one of them. In other words, Class1 is creating the object of Class2 and Class2 is creating the object of Class1. Now the question is, if I go and create the object of Class1, what will happen? So let me put a debug point here and let me run this code. Okay. And let me run this code line by line. So you can see that I am now in my static void main here and I'm creating the object of Class1. So let me go and step in. Now this Class1 actually creates the object of Class2, and Class2 again creates the object of Class1. So it is recursive. You can see that it's going here, it's going here. So it is just dangling up and down, right? Now what's happening eventually is that, you know, these objects are getting created on top of one above another, and it is consuming the memory like anything. And what will happen is, if you run this code in a full run mode now, you should get an exception. So let's wait for some time and we should get an exception. And if you can tell me what the exception is before the code runs, you know, then you are a genius. And okay, in case you have not answered that question in your mind, then you can see that the error is very clear here, and the error is stack overflow exception. Why? Because the objects are created on one above another, and at one moment of time, you know, he is saying that this is an infinite loop here, you can see, and it's an infinite recursion of creation of objects, and I cannot continue ahead, and it just terminates the program. So in other words, if you get this question next time, right, anytime when you go to the .NET interview, then the answer is that the error what you get in such kind of scenarios is the stack overflow exception. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to answer a question, you know, where when one class creates object of other class and the other class again creates object of this class, what will happen? Now, whatever video you have seen, right, is just a glimpse of what we have done. So in case you are interested in our video package, you can go to our site, that is www.class1.com. You can call on this number and you can ask the complete DVD package what we have. So in this DVD package, what we have done is basically we have covered almost everything what a .NET developer wants. So right from basics of ASP.NET, object-oriented programming, SQL Server, to new technologies like WCF, Silverlight, Link, Azure, Entity Framework. We also have UML, architecture, estimation, project management. There is a complete invoicing project end-to-end which is covered, so that you can get a better feel of how to actually create projects in a systematic manner. We have covered server products, you know, both for SharePoint 2007 as well as for 2010. We have a lot of best practices video on SQL Server, etc. So this complete package, you know, you can get from www.class1.com if you're interested, and you can call on this number and you can ask for the rates. It's a very decent rate what we have. On the same, in the same way, you know, as compared to the videos, we also have one more product with us, that is our interview question books. So we have different kinds of interview question books, you know, right from .NET interview questions to SQL Server interview questions, SharePoint interview questions, BizTalk interview questions, etc. So in case you are interested in the books part, you can call on these numbers as per your location. So you can see these numbers on the board at this moment. So I hope that you keep enjoying the videos, you keep seeing our site, and I hope that you gain more knowledge. Thank you very much.